Hey everyone, for this week's model reading log reflection, I read A Sweet Smell of Roses by Angela Johnson, and the illustrations are by Eric Falquez. This book is a unique book as to the illustrations of the book. They are in pencil drawings, except for the exception of each page illustration, there's at least one item that is colored red and sticks out to the readers. This story is about a young girl and her sister Minnie. They go early in the morning before anybody wakes up, and they go to a march during the civil rights. And it gives them that they go past the milkman, they go past the curb market just to get there in time. And they get there with a group, and they hold hands with each other, and they start marching. And they hear the speaker, who happens to be Dr. Martin Luther King, speaking on the megaphone, telling them that they have equal rights, that what they are doing is right, and they deserve better. So they start marching, regardless of, as they say, the crowd hollers at them and tells them they have no rights, which in the illustrations, you can clearly see that the crowd yelling at them is white people. And we all know during the civil rights, the whites and African Americans in their disagreements with everything. But this book is an easy read. I would read it definitely from, you know, younger kids, even before school, but school age kids, I would read K through 3rd, 4th grade, just for the simple fact that the younger kids would sit there and enjoy the story, look at the illustrations, they can notice the red item in each page illustration, while the older kids would coincide this book with some civil rights movements, learning elsewhere in the class. And the title to the book, A Smell of Sweet Roses, I think, it's kind of like a symbol of new roses. We know roses, when they first bloom, blossom, they have a sweet smell to them. And so getting civil rights and African Americans getting the rights they have today is a sweet embrace to them. Something new, something great that happened back in the time. And the activity I would choose for this illustration, possibly the kids could draw depending on the age of class that I would be in, and or there'd be a questions from the book for the older kids, kind of just as I explained, what do they believe the red color on the different illustrations mean in the book. Thank you. Also, the personal reflection of the book that I forgot to mention is I don't have a personal reflection or coincide this with another book, but the reflection that this book could go along with is all the marches or movements that we recently have here in current time in the United States for people marching or protesting for their rights that they believe in. So that's another thing that students could talk about in class, is how the book coincides with equal right movements or marches that we have in our modern time, and compare the different rights to how in the marches, how they handled them. Were they peaceful? Were they not so peaceful? And how they all turned out.